Hello there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and Peter Cruddas is joining us once again, the founder of CMC Markets, because we've got plenty to discuss. We are indeed talking about your results today for 2022. So what we'll do, we'll get you to begin by taking us through the highlights, if you would, Peter.
Yes, good morning, Katie, and thanks for your interest today in CMC Markets and our financial year end. I should also say that I'm not just a founder, I'm the CEO. And look, lots to get through, really. And the exciting bit for me looking at the figures is what we're actually going to be doing in the future, not so much what we did last year. Last year was a great year for us. We tried to, compared to the previous year, it doesn't look like it was a great year. Separated out the COVID period of last year, 2021, because that was insane. I mean, we had record clients, record people were at home. They had more disposable income. We saw the sort of the explosion of cryptocurrencies and then the meme stocks like GameStop. So we've kind of separated it out. And this year's numbers compared to normalized markets in 2020, it's a record year, or our second best year. Last year, COVID was our best year. And the results are a reflection of our strategy over the last 3, 5, 7 years, Project Tuna, targeting high-valued clients, offering the best spreads, great technology, great onboarding, really investing in the business. And the results are coming through now. And that strategy is working. Not only is it more profitable to take more valuable clients, but actually it aligns very well with regulatory changes that we've seen over the last 2 or 3 years. So we're in good shape. We have no debt. We have surplus cash. We've initiated a share buyback scheme because we have so much confidence in the business going forward. What's not to love, really?
All right, I like it. And that share buyback scheme we are going to talk about in just a minute or two. Sure. But first of all, how is the new non-leverage platform? How is that progressing?
So you're right to call it a new non-leverage platform, but it's only new in the UK. We have a very profitable business in Australia, which was basically share trading, options trading of physical products and foreign shares as well there. And that's been a real success story where we white labeled and partnered with ANZ Bank. Effectively, we took on the old E-Trade business that they bought. And that's been very successful. And we're replicating that model in the UK. The platform's launched. It's working. We haven't gone public with it yet. We've released it to our staff. There's a big demand internally. And they're going to help us sort of iron out any issues. But it's a phased release. And the exciting thing about that is that we've launched that platform from just over a year from concept. And it was done using existing technology. So we've taken the Australian technology and other components. And we're going to hit the market big over the next 3 to 6 months. We've got the first phase in, but we're adding other phases like SIPs and ISAs and funds and ETFs. That's all coming through. And it's all been done internally. And what that the real point about the investment platform demonstrates the scale and flexibility that we have with this business. We are leveraging off our existing technology to get into new markets. So we're going to be challenging the investor markets are self-directing. The real opportunity there is not actually technology, it's the commercials. We think it's very expensive for retail clients in this country to invest with their SIP ISAs and when they do foreign shares, when they invest in funds. Our motivation is not just technology, and we're going to replicate what we did in Australia, where we went from number 40 to number 2 retail stockbroker in Australia by driving down spreads, costs of trading. We're going to replicate that model in the UK. So it's not just about technology, it's about capability, but also opportunity. We think it's far too expensive to invest in this country. And that's what we're going to be targeting. It's quite disruptive, quite aggressive, but we do that every day of the week in this business.
All right, then. Let's maybe talk more about kind of what's happening in the future and beyond, and sort of 2023 is going to be a big year and beyond that as well, because you've outlined in your announcement this morning that 2023 will be a year of investment in strategic initiatives to sort of drive net operating income by 30% by 2025. Yes. So maybe just talk through that, if you would.
Well, we also, I mean, if you look at this business now is changing. I mean, you could no longer call us a CFD spread bet provider. There's diversity in the business because of the technology. And as the technology has matured and we've done these partnership deals with different banks, we have nearly 300 different partnership deals around the world. The ANZ deal was a pure non-risk management transaction. It was a pure fintech deal, because they retained the clients. We've now, we don't need to talk about that today, but we can if you want to, we've got time. But what we did was we provided technology to a bank, we executed on a primary exchange, and our part of the process was technology. We didn't onboard the clients. And so the future for us is to build up investment products and our partnerships, our B2B offering. As I say, we're going to build upon the 300 clients, B2B clients that we already have. And we're going to offer B2B in the investment world as well. So if you, you know, if you're in the investment world and you want a platform, you can white label, you can grey label, you can connect to our platform. So what you're seeing, and the presentation we've done to analysts and bankers and investors is the best presentation we've done ever, because it's highlighting the different areas of expansion of the business, all driven by technology. I mean, you know, off the back of an envelope, if you said to me, how much does it cost you to build your investment platform? I would say less than £10 million. Now, if you look around in the marketplace, people spend a huge amount of money. I don't want to mention names here because it's not fair. But some company has come out and said they're going to spend £180 million on their platform. Well, we've built a state-of-the-art platform, which has already 1 million clients on it in Australia. We built it for less than 10 million. We've got so much scale. So we're morphing away from CFD world. We've still got a great business. We're still going to stay in that business and spread bet well. But the real growth for us is through B2B and investments and new opportunities. For example, we said that we're going to open an investment platform in Singapore. We already have a good office there. That comes within the next year. And we've got two or three other opportunities that we're going to keep expanding into. That's why we did the share buyback plan. It shows confidence in our strategy. And I love the share buyback plan. It means my value in the company increases. We've got surplus cash. So I can't think of any other company that I would invest in today other than CMC Markets.
All right. And let's maybe talk further about this share buyback as well, because this is the £30 million share buyback that you've mentioned there. So how is that going? And why do you feel like now is the right time to be buying these shares?
The share buyback's going well. I mean, from my point of view, I'd just like to go out and buy £30 million tomorrow. And, you know, as we buy them, we're pushing the share price up. But there are certain rules and regulations that are surrounding company share buybacks. And, you know, can look those up. But it means we can only buy a certain percentage per day. Mm-hmm. I would like to buy the whole lot in one day. The bottom line is that the board, including myself, feel that as a business, we're undervalued. If you look at our surplus cash, if you look at our technology, if you think about IPO, we IPO'd in 2016 at a price of £2.40. Mm-hmm. Our share price today is around £3.10, £3.15. But since we IPO'd, we've added 1 million clients to our platform. We've signed the biggest partners deal in our history. And we've added £200 million cash to the balance sheet, and we've paid out £200 million in dividend. Now, they're all approximate numbers, okay? So But, you know, the reason our share price is above £3 is because of our share buyback. Prior to the share buyback, our shares were still around £2.40, even despite the fact that we've had all this success and we've added all this value to the balance sheet and we've paid out dividends. So the board feels, and certainly I do as well, that we're undervalued. You know, it's up to people to decide if they agree with me or not. But I haven't sold any shares. I've held all my shares since 2016. And with what we're investing in the company and what we're going to do for the future, I'm very confident, and I'm certainly not selling any shares in this business. And one day the value will come through. I'm sure it will. So that's the honest answer to the question.
All right. A very confident answer as well. You've covered a lot of ground here today, Peter. But just lastly, what are you guiding, forecasting for the year ahead?
My forecast is you should buy shares in CMC, put them in your SIPs and ISA, and hold on to them for the next 3 to 5 years.
All right. Simple. I like it. Peter Cruddas, thank you very much indeed, the founder and CEO of CMC Markets.
Thank you.